sharpening. Instruments should be kept sharp for the following reasons: reducing hand fatigue, improving deposit removal, avoiding burnishing calculus. It will save you time, it will improve your tactile sensitivity, and most importantly, it will minimize your patient's discomfort. Sharpening is determined by using a test stick or a light test. If a blade reflects light on the cutting edge, the instrument is dull. You'll need to replace your instruments when its original shape has been significantly altered. Your work area should be well lit. It should be a table or counter high enough so you can place your elbow on the table and hold the instrument within eye level. If you don't have a counter, you can hold your arm against your body to stabilize your instrument while you're sharpening it. The supplies and materials needed will be safety glasses, gloves if you are in your operatory while working on a patient, cotton tip applicator, gauze, magnifying glass, a plastic stick for testing for sharpness, your clock chart, a cup of water, two stones, one flat and one conical. Prepare the stone by placing it in a cup of water. Remove the wet stone and hold it with your dominant hand, grasping the lower half with your thumb towards you and your fingers away. The instrument is held in your non-dominant hand with a secure palm grasp. The top of the instrument is braced with your index finger. For universal and sickles, the terminal shank is always at 12 o'clock. The terminal shank is the area between the blade and the first angle. The stone is always tipped toward 1 o'clock. The stone is moved in an up and down movement in an overlapping motion. The first instrument we will demonstrate is the sickle scaler. The instrument position. Your instrument is held with the terminal shank at 12 o'clock with the tip towards you at 6 o'clock. The stone position will be 1 o'clock. With an up and down movement, you will then sharpen your blade, starting with the heel third, the middle third, and then the anterior third. Then rotate the instrument the opposite direction and repeat sharpening. Heel third, middle third, anterior third. Remove the sludge, then flip the instrument to the other end, repeating the sharpening technique. Remove the sludge. Next, you will use the conical stone. The conical stone is used to remove any burrs on the instrument following your sharpening. The instruments that will need the conical stone are the anterior sickle, the universals, and the Gracies. Place the conical stone across the blade at 3 and 9 o'clock. Rotate the stone with 3 upward rolling strokes toward you. Then reverse your instrument to the other end and repeat. You are now ready to check for sharpness. You will now be testing for sharpness with your test stick. After each instrument is sharpened, you will need to check for the sharpness with the test stick. Take the sharpened blade and press it against the test stick. Just press and release. It should grab it and you will hear a small, slight ping sound. If you don't have a test stick on your tray, you can use a saliva ejector. The next instrument we will demonstrate is the posterior sickle. Instrument position is your instrument is held with the terminal shank at 12 o'clock with the tip towards you at 6 o'clock. Stone position will be 1 o'clock. Begin sharpening your heel third, your middle third, and your anterior third. Then rotate your instrument the opposite direction and repeat the sharpening technique. Remove the sludge. Flip the instrument to the other end and begin sharpening with your stone at 1 o'clock, your terminal shank at 12, and the tip away from you. Okay, you will start with your heel third, middle third, then your anterior third. Okay. Now rotate your instrument and begin sharpening. Heel third, middle third, anterior third. Noticing at all times your terminal shank is at 12 o'clock and the stone is always at 1. Now it's time to check against a test stick. And you'll be checking 4 blade surfaces. The next instrument that we will be demonstrating is the universal curette. The universal curette has 2 parallel cutting edges and a rounded toe. Hold the instrument in your non-dominant hand. The terminal shank will be at 12 o'clock and the toe towards you at 6 o'clock. Once again, your stone will be at 1 o'clock. Begin sharpening in your 3 segments. Then rotate the instrument so that the toe is pointing away from you, repeating the sharpening technique. Wipe the sludge and now flip the instrument to the other end, repeating the sharpening technique with the terminal shank at 12 o'clock and the stone at 1, starting with the toe towards you. You are now ready to sharpen the toe. Rotate the toe towards 3 o'clock. Place the stone at 3 and tip it to 2 o'clock. With a light motion, rotate it up and down around the toe. Then, with a sweeping upward motion, slide the back of the stone across the back of the blade. By doing this, you will preserve the shape of the instrument. Now, flip your instrument. Repeat the same technique to sharpen the toe at the other end. Now you will follow up with your finishing technique with the conical stone. With the toe facing you, place the stone at 3 and 9 o'clock. With 3 upward motions, roll the stone across the face of the instrument. Then reverse it to the other end and complete the technique. You're now ready to test your instrument against a testing stick.